I don't really see why people make such a big deal about going through puberty. Like, it's such a terrible thing, like the most, like, worst thing you experience in your life. Because honestly, going through your 20s seems to be like 10 times worse. I'm like not even 23 yet, and like this shit's already worse than puberty. What's up, everybody? Happy Mental Illness Awareness Week. So about 1 year from like around this time, I don't really have an exact date. I probably can just look it up on YouTube because the date is on the video. But I started my YouTube channel back up. So it's been 1 year since like kind of revamping it. For those of you who don't know, I started YouTube doing YouTube videos, I think like my freshman year of college. And honestly, like I didn't really have a direction. I was just trying to be funny. And like people say I'm a funny person, I consider myself to be funny, but like not on command. Like the things I'm funny for are like just like not that. So I was forcing it. And it wasn't until last year that I was like, I need to start doing something that like I care about. And honestly, talking about my experience with mental illness and mental health and just like this whole struggle with being bipolar has been bigger than I thought it was going to be. I'm super passionate about it, obviously, because I'm like dealing with it 24/7 and it like destroying my life. But it's also the sense that, you know, I didn't think that I would be talking about this for a year. I didn't think that I would care as much as I do about it. I didn't think that I would receive like so much feedback for doing it. And I think that's just really been great. And this video really isn't about, you know, me saying thank you to y'all, but I am saying, not to sound rude or anything, but thank you to those of you who do watch my videos, who are there. You guys are amazing, and I'm excited for another year to, you know, find out what I'm gonna be going through, obviously, because I'm always going through something. Today, I wanted to talk about, I think, which is completely fitting, now that I've sort of done that little intro there. You know, I feel like I'm in crisis, and I don't really know if, like, I really am in crisis, or if it just, you know, I always feel like I'm teetering on the edge of, like, destruction. So, recently, I've been going through this whole thing about, you know, not worrying about where I am in life. It sounds like so, like such a large issue. Not I don't know where I am in life. But honestly, yeah, trying to live in the moment. So what living in the moment for me personally means, because people say live in the moment all the time, like you're doing coke at 3 a.m., live in the moment. Yeah, no. For me, living in the moment means not really worrying about, you know, what's gonna be happening like a month from now or even 2 months. I often typically try to plan like my life months in advance. So like this time last year, I remember I was literally planning what I was gonna be doing in the winter, school-wise, job-wise, all of that. I was like applying for jobs. I wasn't applying for grad schools, but I was looking at grad schools, and I was looking at places to live in Atlanta. I literally had an Excel spreadsheet of all the different apartments that I could possibly live in Atlanta, so that when time came to it, like I already knew what areas, I already knew so much about them. I'm very like anal in that sense, in that like I need to know my future, and it needs to be, I don't like surprises. I remember I was like at least in grammar school, I had to have been 7 years old. I was going to therapy, because you know I started therapy when I was 4. Yeah. I was in therapy and I had this book, you know, and it had sort of like a journal of my summer, because I spent my summers with my dad here in Atlanta, grew up in Chicago, you know, visit my dad because my parents were divorced, blah, blah, blah. And I would, you know, I created this journal about my schedule for each day. It had every single day of the summer that I would be there. And it had time blocked out because my dad would always take us on, you know, I would go visit him for the summers. So that's like my sort of vacation, but also we'd go on a vacation from there. So I had time blocked out for that because I didn't know what it was going to look like. But for every other day, you know, I had my wake up time. I had like when I was going to eat lunch, I had like what activities we're going to do. I had like it was like, and, you know, I never really followed it because like obviously things change, you can't plan it to the T like that, but it was the fact where like I had a good idea about like how my summer was gonna look. So anyway, I've been doing it since I was a kid. I'm not sure if that's like normal now that I've said it out loud. I'm like, maybe if there's something, I don't know if that's like a safety mechanism or like I feel insecure about the future, which I do. I feel very uncomfortable about not knowing the future, which is why I've decided, you know, to start living in the moment. So for example, I am dating somebody new, and that has been interesting. But I am not thinking about the future because, well, one, It's a very complicated situation that I have not gotten into you with y'all. I'm not thinking about, you know, whether or not they'll be here next month, you know, or, you know, next year. I'm literally just thinking about like, hey, what are we doing this week? When am I seeing you today? This is what's going on. Same thing for work. I'm really concerned about, you know, whether or not some performance, I'm doing fine at my job. But, you know, in terms of like getting to that next level, I want to excel at my job higher. But I'm not trying to worry about that because that's sort of out of my power. So I can only focus on what do I have to do at work today? For grad schools, what do I have to do to prepare? Like, you know, I'm applying to grad school in 2 years. But like, you know, I don't have to just try to like breathe. So that's been my whole thing recently. And it's really hard because I feel like everything is on fire around me. And I'm literally just trying to remain calm so that I don't freak out, because I am living in, literally, this is what they like, you know, I'm living in my 20s, and I feel like there's no difference. Like, yes, I have bipolar disorder. Yes, I have anxiety. Yes, I have OCD. Yes, I have trauma. Yes, I have all these things that make life super hard, but I'm also like 22 at the same time, and I just graduated from college, and like a lot of the things that I'm feeling like probably like aren't that like significant to me. It might be harder for me to deal with them. Like, I have panic attacks and stuff, but like, don't we all have panic attacks? So I don't know. I'm trying to give myself credit in the sense that like, I do know that like, I have some difficult things going on in my life regarding my brain, and regarding like how I regulate my mood and things that I do. And like, I don't feel depressed, actually. Wow, that's a revelation. I have not felt sad, like wanting to die sad in a while. Like I did the last few videos, like basically the last 2 months, or the last month, really just, I guess, September with a week of October. I don't feel that way, but I do feel impending doom, like I just, like, everything's on fire, and I'm just sitting here like that. Like, I'm thinking of the dog meme. You know what I'm talking about? The dog meme, the dog's just sitting there, and it's like, this is fine, because I don't know what to do, but I'm, like, kind of happy that I don't know what to do. It bothered me at first, and it still bothers me. But I'm trying not to let it bother me. And I think for Mental Illness Awareness Week, the reason why this is important to me is that it's something that I'm constantly thinking about. I'm constantly thinking about my mood. I'm constantly thinking about my anxiety, thinking about like my behavior, especially whether or not like, is me living in the moment, not worrying about these significant life issues, because they are significant things that I eventually will have to think about. But is it me not thinking about them now like a bad thing? Like, is it me just like, am I doing life the right way? That's what I want to know. Like, there's no right or wrong way to do life. And no one can tell you. I'm a firm believer in that. There's certain ways you should do life. Like, maybe doing crack and like, that's probably not the best. But like, no one can tell you your right path. It has to be right for you. And with someone like who has bipolar disorder, I don't know sometimes like, if that path is like me being manic, me being depressed, me being like psychotic and not really knowing what's going on. Because I've made some choices in the last few weeks that I think the old me, I don't know that, I don't think there is a new me yet, but like past versions of myself would not have been comfortable with. And I'm not ready to talk about those things yet, but I do think that I'm trying to find myself, which is so cliche and weird to say. Find the new me, and it's the new me beyond bipolar disorder. Last year it was consumed by like, I'm bipolar, this consumes my life. Now I think it's like, I'm just dealing with freaking life issues and I have bipolar disorder on the side, and I think it's kind of quiet. And by kind of quiet right now, I mean it's been quiet for like 2 weeks and I think like life is great. Or I could just be manic right now, because that also is like how I typically feel, or hypomanic. I don't really feel manic, but like I definitely could be hypomanic because I have had some of those symptoms, and that's also like why I could be like not depressed and I haven't really been taking my medicine. So that also, like, this is what I'm talking about. Like, am I really happy or am I like hypomanic? Like, do we know? Am I making the right life choices? I'm rambling now, but y'all get it. So happy Mental Illness Awareness Week. I am not really sure exactly what I'm doing video-wise for this, but you can always follow me on Instagram, as I will be sharing a whole bunch of stuff there this week for y'all to check out, which will be really awesome. And of course, obviously, I'm going to continue uploading videos. So like, share, and comment on this video. Subscribe to find out when I'm uploading new videos. Y'all are the best. Love y'all. Have a great week.